What's up, witches? It's Stella out in the evening, and today's video is a continuation of my Faerie series, and it is going to be on the Kelpie today. Not to be confused with the Selkie, they are very, very different. So, Kelpie, spelled K-E-L-P-I-E, usually. The Kelpie, again, got my book, got me information. Why the accent? What the hell was that? I have no idea. I'm getting a bit tired. I've made quite a few videos today. The Kelpie is a Scottish creature often associated with the realm of Faerie. It also falls into the classification of water horse, although this one is decidedly malevolent. It most commonly appears as a beautiful horse in or near running water. It can be identified by the mane that seems to be constantly dripping wet. Or other depictions have the mane as seaweed. Just FYI. Females will sometimes appear as beautiful women dressed in green, bent on luring lustful men into their watery doom. The Kelpie would seem like an easy thing to avoid, thus keeping oneself safe from the danger it presents. However, when encountered, they are alone, bridled and saddled, and ready to ride. This presents an enticing invitation to a weary traveller. There are other reasons to seek out these dangerous beasts too. A Kelpie is said to have magical powers that someone who captures it can use to their advantage. They have the strength of 10 normal horses and endurance far beyond that. The key to capture is the bridle. If one can use a Kelpie bridle on the beast, then it has no choice but to serve the master of the bridle. But capturing and holding a Kelpie, or any fey creature for that matter, is considered a very, very dangerous prospect and one that will not be forgiven. Having said that, capture may be the only way to get the Kelpie to listen long enough to work with you if you plan to work with them, if you work with the Unseelie court or kind of more on the edge type of fae. Again, to reiterate, to capture any kind of fae or force it to work with you is never going to end well, like at all, not recommending, seriously, don't do it. But if you want to work with a Kelpie, then it might be the only way to get it to listen to you. So, yeah, reiterate, don't try to encapture and enslave different types of fae, or any type of fae, good or bad, because it's not going to end up well for you. It's just really not. They are not to be trifled with, seriously. Moving on. Merely touching these creatures activates one form of its magic, the ability to adhere human's flesh to its own. The Kelpie also has a tail that can be smacked on the water with such force that a clap of thunder is emitted, and basically results in like a tidal wave. The resulting flood can drag a human into the water where the Kelpie will hold them until they die. If you wish to work with the Kelpie, don't touch it. Seriously, don't touch them. They have the power to just adhere your flesh to theirs and you won't be able to get off. And there is actually a story of a child who found a Kelpie, tried to touch it, just to like stroke its nose with a finger, got adhered to. They did manage to escape, but they had to cut their finger off. Be careful of Kelpies. Seriously, please. For your own safety. Moving on! As the Kelpie is a water horse, many legends of Scotland can be attributed to its race. Even the famous Loch Ness Monster could be a Kelpie. Nearly every river, stream or lake in Scotland has a Kelpie legend, so this dangerous creature can't easily be avoided for the unwary traveller. It is particularly attractive to children, but they should take care, for once on its back, its sticky magical hide will not allow them to dismount. Once trapped in this way, the Kelpie will drag the child into the river and then eat him. Again, unseelie, dangerous, creepy as hell. Be careful! There is another water horse called the... I'm going to butcher this so badly, but the I'm going to call it Yakuiske. I don't know. I will, on the screen, come on, just down here. Yeah, that's how it's spelled. Help. I don't speak Scottish. I don't speak kind of any of the Celtic languages at all. Help me. So the Yakuiske, which lurks in lochs and is said to be even more vicious than the Kelpie. There is the Nuggle of Orkney, the Shupilty of Shetland, and the Cabiltushti of the Isle of Man, and the Cathaldoya of Wales. While appearing in human form, the Kelpie will still have its hooves, which is one reason, or one way, to be able to tell that there is a Kelpie near you. And the females can shapeshift to appear as kind of like beautiful young women, but the males are almost always just horses. In the past, human sacrifices were made to appease the gods and spirits of the waters. In time, this practice led to the belief in the evil water horse, and there are some stories, however, that paint Kelpies in a more positive light. In these stories, they are said to protect small children from drowning in lakes and warned young women to be wary of handsome strangers. So, yes, Kelpies are unseelie, they are negative, they are malevolent, they are bad, they are very, very dangerous, so be careful. But as with every creature, there can be a light and a dark side of it. And the lighter side of the Kelpie is that it may protect women from lustful, creepy strangers, and it can protect children from drowning in its lake or river. But it is not as common to find a good Kelpie as it is to find a bad one. So again, be careful. They can live in water as well as on land. In most legends, they appear as strong and beautiful black horses, and they can also appear as white as well. They are very common. The hooves of the Kelpie are thought to be reversed to those of a regular horse. So instead of it facing kind of like that way, it will face like that way, I guess. Great depiction. I'm so good at charades, you know. As well as on land, thought to be reversed to a regular horse. Some specific local legends are... give different appearances. For example, in Aberdeenshire, the Kelpie has a mane of snakes, and the River Spey Kelpie was white and could sing. Apart from humans, these malevolent water creatures also feed on cattle and sheep. You are apparently only possibly safe to touch a Kelpie or Ikusige if you are absolutely nowhere near water. So Kelpies are possibly only safe if you are absolutely nowhere near any bodies of water. If they see water, they will drag you into it, they will kill you, they will eat you. Basically, that's what the legends say. Now, I have no experience with Kelpies, as they are mostly found in Scotland, and I've never been to Scotland. Almost went this year, but that kind of got cancelled because quarantine. Great. But yeah, the Kelpie is a very, very Scottish legend. It's not likely to be found many other places, even in rural areas like Ireland or Scotland. Scotland, Cornwall, like where I live. They are most likely found around lochs and lakes and rivers, and they are very, very malevolent beings, mostly. You will find the odd outlier that helps, but mostly they are malevolent beings. So if you do wish to work with them, again, be incredibly careful, don't touch them, try not to be anywhere near them if you're with water. So if you're doing a meditation with a Kelpie, have it be in a neutral, like non-watery zone, if you can. And yeah, just seriously be safe. Because I know this is a kind of how-to or like info video, but if you do use the information that I've given you here and try to work with the Kelpies, be safe, be responsible. And yeah, please don't let it eat you, because I don't want to feel responsible for that. Thanks. So, as I don't have any experiences with Kelpies, then I think that wraps up this video. So, be unapologetically you, no shame. Be careful, be safe, and I will see you in the next one.